Welcome everybody. This is the spring jazz concert with 7th through 12th grade. In front of you, you have the Hudson Middle School Jazz Ensemble made up of 7th and 8th grade students. Again, we meet twice a week, but just to give you an idea how involved these kids are in everything they do, they don't know I'm gonna do this. Raise your hand if, aside from jazz, on any given jazz day, you happen to have had something else this year, maybe sports or a club or an honor society or something that you're also partaking in on some jazz days. So, pretty cool. These kids are able to do it all. And so when people say you can't do music and something else, it's just that, nope, not true. You can totally do both. High schoolers, how many of you that are sitting out there right now do more than music in high school? There you go. So, multi-talented kids here. And our first tune is called Did I Say That Out Loud? And it's a tune that I picked up from a gentleman named Ray Ames, who is a, I'm not sure if he's retired, I need to check on this, but a retired or a still teaching Wisconsin educator. So he's writing these tunes. Thought it'd be fun to kind of dig one of these out and try it out. And we're gonna have a couple of soloists. We're gonna have James Gavin on trumpet, and we're gonna have Ryan Arthur on alto saxophone. Every microphone is different. I should have looked at that in advance. Sorry about that. But One thing I should tell you about, and some of you would be aware of this, but our jazz ensembles from Hudson went to the University of Wisconsin River Falls a couple weeks ago, and we got to perform, and each group got to perform for a clinician and have a master class and basically learn a little bit more about jazz and dig deeper into it. So our clinician for the middle school was Laura Caviani, and she's a really, really fantastic educator, performer, and jazz pianist in the Twin Cities and elsewhere. She's awesome, and I would say she was pretty cool. Did you guys like her?
Yeah.
So we learned a ton that day, and we got to go to master classes learning specifically about our own instruments, and we got to see University of Wisconsin River Falls perform with their top jazz ensemble with a world-renowned trombone player named Alan Ferber. And he was pretty amazing too, would you say?
Yeah.
So hopefully it was a worthwhile day. You're like, yes, good answer. All right. So our next tune, for a lot of you, probably needs no introduction. It's very, very well known, Pennies from Heaven. Right, I don't know if you can see this, but if you can, and you can see this very retro cover from the 1970s, total awesome hair, nice, okay. That is a sketch of Bob Mintzer. And Bob Mintzer is one of the most famous jazz saxophone players, still alive, playing. He plays, do you guys know the Yellow Jackets? Some of your parents might, yeah. So he's kind of one of the lead people in that group, among many, many, many other things. Phenomenal. So we're doing a tune by Bob Mintzer, and we have a number of soloists on this one. So we have Carson Feiereisen back on trumpet. We have Josh, trombone. We have Carnigan, tenor saxophone. And hopefully I didn't miss anybody. Okay, silence, we're good. Okay. Before we play the last piece, it's called Malaguena, and I have to tell you, I don't know if I told you guys this, I don't remember, but this was one of the very first pieces that I played when I was their age, and I started jazz band in sixth grade, and I was so short that I couldn't actually like stand up to be tall enough to stand next to all my peers that were sixth, seventh, and eighth graders, and I had to sit on top of a bass amp in order, yeah. So, but this is a distinct memory because I remember Malaguena and I remember feeling so much passion and this type of music I've never heard before. Just, it's really driving and it's really electric. And if you don't know it, you're in for a treat. If you do, we hope you enjoy. And then also just one last plug here, that Friday morning, the middle school jazz band is gonna be playing before school again and doing a before school concert where we're gonna be doing, it's called Bagels and Blues. Some of you already know about it because they've gotten permission forms coming in. Some of you still have to turn them in. Awesome. So this Friday morning, starting at about 7:10 a.m., we'll start selling bagels and all the proceeds go back to the Angel Fund at the middle school so that we can help out other Hudson families that are in need to help pay for field trips and school supplies and all sorts of other things that come up for all of us at some point in time. And so it's really cool to give back. It's their second time this year of doing this. And then they get to play for their peers and their teachers and whoever else happens to come around. It's a lot of fun. So if you have a chance and you happen to be awake at, oh my gosh, 1:00 in the morning, come on by. You're more than welcome to come check it out and just support and hang out. So with that being said, our last piece, Malaguena. And this is all about the kids, but I have to say, I can't begin to tell you how much fun I have working with them all the time. And it's what makes me tick. It's what makes me come wanting to be here every single day and wanting to keep learning and trying and just thriving every single day. So I just want to say a thank you to the kids for working so hard and letting me work with you and really stepping it up. So thank you guys.
Thank you very much. This is the High School Jazz Lab Band, and we pulled the old switcheroo on you tonight. We opened with You and Me, and we're going to finish tonight with How High the Moon. Special thanks to Maddie Bronner on the tenor sax, featured on You and Me. Nice job, Maddie. And this morning around 8:30, Emily Thorson, our bass player, came in to me and said, "I'm going. I just threw up." Bye. See you later. Go get better. So I wanted to send a shout out, special thanks to Jack Johnson from our Jazz One, sitting in with us tonight, helping us out. Thanks, Jack. Yeah. We're gonna finish with the jazz standard, How High the Moon. This is gonna feature Skye Hansen. Let's see here, see if I can get the order right on this. Skye Hansen, Ryan Harper, Brady Lundquist, Haley Sparks, Claire Simonson, Kenzie Farrell, and we were debating whether or not we were gonna have some spoken word in the middle of it, but I think we've opted against it. We may set up a secondary spring tour. We'll call it the spoken word tour. So keep your eyes on your social medias. We'll see if we can make that happen. We'll lay off on that tonight, but if there's an audience for it, we'll work to put that together. This is How High the Moon.
Thank you. Thank you. This is the Hudson High School Jazz 2, Jazz Ensemble 2, and that was a Doug Beach composition called 6x6, and you heard solos from Luke Samas, Zach Boilo, Harley Lentz, Jacob Cumming, and James Wallace. We're going to play another composition of Doug Beach's. This is sort of a Latin jazz tune called Los Reyes de Plata. And you will hear solos on this one from Joe Norris, Emily Ron, John Vegan, and Jack. Jack Curtis. Jack Curtis. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is our top jazz ensemble. It is actually a class. They get credit for this. We meet outside of the school on Monday evenings and Thursday mornings. They come in at 6:45 a.m., about an hour and a half before their colleagues have to be at school. But we have really productive rehearsals those mornings. I'm filling time as our vibraphonist goes and gets a few more mallets. But thank you so much for being here. Thank you to Ms. Brown and Mr. McCarthy for the work that they do with our program. And thanks to all of you for the support that you offer all these students. We're very aware that the stuff like this wouldn't happen without you paying for lessons, paying for instruments, driving them to late night rehearsals, driving them to performances, remembering and bringing their music when they forget it. So thank you so much for the work that you do. And we're really happy to share this music with you. This first tune is a Duke Ellington composition, very old Duke Ellington from the 30s, called Blue Feeling. That was Brandon Furman, Audrey Gerges, Hannah Arthur, and Dalton Amundsen on the solos on those tunes. We had the We're very lucky, being so close to the Twin Cities, to be able to tap into the resources that are the jazz ensemble, jazz scene there in the Twin Cities. They're wonderful composers and musicians in town. And our next two tunes are both written by local composers. The first one is a nice, short, mysterious tune by a local trumpet player, Bill Simonson. And the one after that is a saxophonist that we got to work with. He came in and worked with our bands courtesy of Eckroth and Schmidt Music, Aaron Hedenstrom, who wrote Honeybee, which is our third tune. This tune is going to feature a little bit of free improvisation up front by Karina Miller, Cy Miller, and Brendan Hayes. Isn't that curious? Very interesting character. He's very short. Bill Simonson likes to write short little tunes to put in between the music that he plays. It's a little more long form. This next tune, Aaron Hedenstrom, local saxophonist, wrote for his wife. It's titled Honeybee. Thank you. that featured a lot of Cy Miller on drums and some very nice flavoring by Kate Lowry on the piano. We have one more selection for you. Thanks again for being here and for all of your support. Supporting the arts and supporting live music and supporting schools is important. So thank you for that. Our last tune is a little more back to the roots of jazz, not all the way back to Duke Ellington, about halfway between now and Duke Ellington. This is a Charles Mingus tune, and it deserves a little explanation because it is about a particular historic event. This tune comes to us from the civil rights era. We have to acknowledge, playing this music, that the history of jazz is very much the history of African Americans and black people in the US. And this tune is titled Fables of Faubus, after the governor of Arkansas in the 60s, Orville Faubus, who, when faced with the integration of schools, mind you, this is about 8 to 10 years after Brown versus Board of Education, when finally they were hitting those deadlines where they had to integrate schools, four black students were arranged to go across the road to the white school, and after losing all of his local battles to stop that, the governor called in the National Guard and had them close the school down. And this is Mingus's reaction musically to that event.
Thank you. Thank you.
Max Reynolds, Ethan Seth, Brendan Hain, Jeremiah Tank, Rebecca Tank on the solos. Thank you again.